hotel services, and they have distributed more than 10 lakh meals. Roti program. D. Shivananda sir has co-authored a wonderful book with Dr. Radhakrishnan Pillai called Seven Pillars of Leadership, whereby they extensively he has discussed how every aspect of leadership is applicable to the policy. Along with him, now with us will be Professor Natarajan, who will help us make more sense of this whole conversation. He will come in after the talk of D. Shivanandan sir. Dr. Natarajan, I don't know how much to introduce and how much not to introduce, but he is the biggest vitreoretinal surgeon, and most notably the Jammu and Kashmir government has an award offered given to him for treating the highest number of eye injuries, the pellet injuries to the eye. He's got numerous foundations in charge and they are principally involved in researching heritable eye diseases. To both these gentlemen, my apologies if I have gone short in introducing you all, but I won't want to take any more time, and over to you, sir, Shivanandan sir, for your talk.
Thank you, Dr. Tushar Agarwal, and thank you, Dr. Neeraj Bijlani, and thanks for all the other doctors who joined here for this talk. And at the outset, I want to thank one young doctor here, Dr. Rudra, son of Dr. Toraskar. And he has helped me in setting up this computer and things like that, which I am not completely aware of. So he has done a wonderful job. I thank him also. He's sitting with me listening to this. I would like to say in the beginning that I'll cover about 40 minutes of my presentation, and then 20 minutes we can have a freewheeling discussion. You can ask any question for which I have no prepared answer. There is no kind of beating down the bush. You will get the answer as direct as you would like it to be. So with that, I would say that I have done all this checking about what is this doctors and COVID business. So this COVID has come and changed the entire way we work and we sleep and then we treat people. Everything is complete, office going, business doing, even the war, waging the war has completely changed. A new normal has come. In the bargain, we are comparing the lives of, let us say, the army men, the police officers and the doctors. When it comes to the army man or the policeman, we have a defined enemy. His face is visible to us. We give them a target. When I was joint CP crime, I used to give the top 10 list in the Times of India. His name is there. People would hunt the enemy by a name, photograph and fingerprint, that too. Whereas for the doctors as on today, the enemy is absolutely invisible. You don't know whether the enemy is floating in the air or is floating in the water or on the surface or in the shoes. What is it? So when the doctors go with the COVID dress, completely their suit and booter, they'll be sweating like anything. So that is the problem. When I checked with the Google, I found out that at least not less than 100 doctors and more of the other staff have passed away due to the coronavirus. It's a very depressing scene to talk about it, so I'm not going to talk about it. But if at all we compare police and the doctors as people, as first responders to any emergency, first responders are the police and the next will be the doctors, medical hospitals and all, we can say, if it is a consolation, I can't even say it's a consolation, 35,000 policemen and officers have died from 1947 to 2019. Every year we do a parade on October 21st, 8 o'clock in all the districts of India, sharp 8 o'clock, the chief minister would go at the capital and attend a parade where martyrs list is read out and we pay homage to them every year. So I know the figures. Last year was 682. Mostly people die of CRP. For example, last year we lost people in the Pulwama attack, 40 of them. And in Gadchiroli, our own Gadchiroli, 15 commandos were blown up in a landmine. I have worked there for 3 years, 1995 to 1998, and then came for the bullets were flying in Mumbai to control that. I had come here from landmines to bullet. That is my journey, and that's what I'm going to talk about. So in that, I wanted to say that a story can be recited with your permission, that a thief went to see a circus. And then there was a fire around a fire circle of fire. And there was a man who jumped into that very easily without any fright whatsoever. The thief thought, come on, let us recruit him. He offline, he went there and contacted him. He said, how much do you earn? 1,000 rupees a day, he said. I'll pay you 10,000 rupees if you can come with me. He said, okay, come on, let's go and try. So both of them went in the middle of the night and he showed a three-storied bungalow where there was an open window, an open hole or a window or an AC vent where one man could only go inside. This man being adept in going inside, he told him, go there and steal all the gold and money and come back. There, the catch, the twist of the story comes. The circus man said, produce 5,000 people in here in this as my audience. Unless they go on clapping, I don't get the encouragement to go there and jump into the fire ring and come out without any problem. Now, that is what is the doctor's need today. I wanted to convey my appreciation to all of you, saying that I am those one of the 5,000 audience who is clapping. Prime Minister Modi flew those helicopters and flights and all that over hospital to pay homage. In today's my presentation, I wanted to share my appreciation and my salutations to all of you, saying that if you are the circus person risking your life and jumping into the fire ring every day and night, every day in and day out, I am one of those 5,000 people who are clapping continuously for your performance. So with that, we can say, policeman, I gave you the number, 35,000 people have died. I would like to draw your attention to the Satkankulam incident here, the corona damage.
Sir, excuse me, sir. There is a lot of static. Is there a wind incoming to your room?
Yeah, close to that. Yes.
And are you supposed to move your slide?
Yeah, I would.
Slide is at one, number one only. Rudraksh, are you there?
I'm moving. So here is the circus story that I told you. I found out these pictures of all the doctors and the medical staff who have passed away during this coronavirus. That's within these 3 months or 4 months. So my homage to you, I gave you the circus story. Now here, I would like to show how do you achieve success. This is a minute. Minutes video, kindly bear with that. You can see how do you reach a stage where you can call yourself a successful people. Come on. Try. So this is the summary of all the successful people. whether it is Thomas Alva Edison or Madame Curie or whoever it is there. There's very successful people are those people who stood there in the arena and then quit when things were going wrong. It is whether it is a policeman or a doctor or anybody, there can be 1,000 failures. But when you stand in the arena and give a tough fight, we don't know which moment you will be a successful person. So that is what I would like to say to all the doctors who are fighting the coronavirus, that you have to be there. You can't quit at all. You have to take precautions. You can't get paranoid about it. You can't feel depressed about it. Why feel depressed whenever I read in the newspaper that somebody or the other is committing suicide? Not doctors, the others, because of the corona and various other issues. So that is the issue. Talking, summarizing what is happening in the corona, this is what it is. We will not go back to normal. Normal never was. Our pre-corona existence was not normal, other than we normalized greed. You can compare it with the doctors or apply to the doctors. We get normalized greed, iniquity, exhaustion, depletion, extraction, disconnection, confusion, rage and anger, hoarding, hate and lack of what we have and we don't have. So we should not long to return, my friends. We are being given the opportunity to stitch a new garment, a new fabric, one that fits all of humanity and nature. This is what I found it to be absolutely fitting to the doctors. So everything is temporary. Don't stress. If anyone knows Tamil, it says, Iduvum kadandu povum. Iduvum kadandu povum. Dr. Natarajan will give an explanation later. That means this is absolutely a passing by thing, temporary. Don't get stressed about it. Move on. We will get a vaccine, we'll get a cure, and we will definitely outlive this coronavirus. You are strong enough to fight through this and you are not alone. But the need is to nurture the plant of success, as I've shown you that picture, you have to, the video, you have to be there and fight and see that this plant, which is a seed as an idea, has to grow into a great oak tree. All the doctors or all the policemen should say every time that I have been fighting since I was a child. Most of us were not able to afford our education or upbringing, and we were not competent to compete with all the others, but we have made it. Whether it is Dr. Badrinath or Dr. Devi Shetty or Dr. Natarajan, everybody has been a fighter. So we can say that very proudly that I have been fighting since I was a child. I am not a survivor. I am a warrior. I am not a loser. I am a winner. I am not a victim. I am the victor. If that is the attitude of all the doctors, I am sure we will come out as winners by the end of the thing. I thought I'll show you this cartoon, where these corporate hospitals are making use of this coronavirus and all the pharma companies are there ready with fake vaccine like your Ramdev Baba or various other vaccines, but they're out to make money out of that. I hope the humanity will survive this kind of attitude also. The doctors may take offense to this, but I thought I'll convey this to you. So here, the success tip is that I survived because of the fire inside me burned brighter than the fire around me. Firefighting has been our job. As the first responders, the police and the doctors and the various others have been firefighting. We got burnt most of the times. And then we always say, attribute our success to the fire in the belly. There are many first timers who have uneducated parents who have come out on top, made it to the Nobel Prize winning the list. With a Nobel Prize list, they have made it because of the fire in the belly and the starvation they faced at the young age. So courage, I would like to say that all the leaders would have 7 characters to make them on top of the world. One is a great vision. The second is a great passion with which they attend to their work. And the third is the courage with which they go to the hospital daily, wear that oppressing suit and sweat it out and face the corona patients. And the fourth is the competence to handle any crisis. Through education, they get that. character is that honesty, bearing with that, the oppression, the suppression, whatever is happening, the courage to face as with a square face is the next character. Ingredient of a leader. The next is self-image, and the last but not is the discipline. 7 words, doctors: vision, passion, courage, competence, character. Character means honesty, humility. There is a book I read by James Collins called The Level 5 Leadership. 1,465 CEOs were compared and they were interviewed. They found out those leaders like Indira Nooyi or Satya Nadella or Sundar Pichai suffer from humility, honesty, innovation, and communicating with the people, the best communicators they are. So like this, the 5 qualities are what they found out in those level 5 leaders. So courage is one of them. So you need the courage, and we are here as the people who will clap and see that you go in and come out. So passion, I mentioned, it is the burning desire. You give 100% to that. For us in the police, at least for me, it is 365 days. I never had a holiday, and it was 24/7. The phone was on. It was never off. Anybody called me at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock in the morning, I answered, called Shivaji Nagar or Devanar police station and sorted out their problem and then slept. I mentioned about the discipline. Discipline is the bridge between goals and accomplishment. What do you want to achieve and where you are? So innovation is the ability to see change as an opportunity, not as a threat. It is very, very relevant to the present issue of Corona. Can we come up with these innovations in Make in India or Made in India? Whatever Prime Minister Modi says, unless we come up with innovations where we produce all these things, how many companies which left China in disgust have come to India? Out of 36, 3 companies have come, other 33 have gone to Vietnam, Cambodia, Indonesia, and other countries, Malaysia and other countries. So we need to innovate, my dear doctor friends. So risk taking is another leadership quality. All of you are taking risk day in and day out. But then while taking the risk, you have to be absolutely informed about it. When you take risk, you have to have a 360 degree vision as to what is surrounding you and what you are taking risk about, and then go into the arena and be a gladiator. Gladiator is what you people are, and you have to be the winner, not the victim. So if you are not willing to risk the unusual, you will have to settle for the ordinary. They are not the Nobel Prize winners who are the ordinary left in the arena as the people who have been lost in the game. So if you want to be successful, don't seek success, seek competence. Do nothing short of the best. These are the qualities which I mentioned earlier. Vision is the art of seeing what is invisible to the others. The long vision is where you go. If I request all of you to read a book called The 100-Year Marathon of the Chinese Policy of Bringing US Down, and then become number one in the world, which they are trying to do now. The new act which they are doing is because of that. For that, they are setting up a policy and following a 100-year marathon. That is from 1949 to 2049, from Mao to Xi. That is what they are doing, and that is what we also need to do. A leader is the one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. In this, the leader has to bring up people who are successors, who are becoming as big as them. There can't be a jealousy. And they have to accept the success and failures as theirs. Dr. Abdul Kalam absolutely brings it up. The first rocket which fell into the sea, Tumba, then the Dr. Satish Dhawan, his boss, said, I will go and face the media and the press and take the responsibility. From Sriharikota, the next one went up to the sky soaring. It became a big success. Dr. Satish Dhawan said, you go and face the press and take all the accolades. Can we do that? If we can do that, then you are a born leader. Humility is the best form of warfare. It is the only thing the enemy cannot do, whether it is Chinese or any other enemy. Anyway, Sun Tzu has written a book called The Art of War. If you all find time, kindly read that. You will understand how the Chinese would do or what are their tactics. So everybody, this one is very common about ordinary people like me or you or others, is life is not about finding yourself intact. It is, life is all about creating yourself. If one is a bulk of dust and stone pieces, we'll have to chisel out what exactly you want to be looking like. That's a Michelangelo working around, and that has to be you and can't be anybody else. There is nothing called destiny or horoscope or predetermined thing and all that. There are people without hands and limbs who have made history. So that is the kind of destiny we have to write about. So my plea with all of you is to go out into the world with your passion and love for what you do and just never give up, corona or no corona. I come back to a small story of, let us say, about 20 minutes from now. I'll finish this. This is about my own experiment from 98 to 2001. This is a turnaround story where the pinnacle of glory of these thieves who I'm showing you, the mafia, Mumbai mafia, was shooting people to death from 1960 to 2001, 2002. In that, the height of the fright in Mumbai city, whoever is old enough like me would know, is that in 1998, they had shot 101 businessmen in 1 year. That is every three and a half days, one businessman was shot. Either Taqiyuddin Wahid of the East West Airlines, or Sunit Katav of the Katav Mills, or anybody for that matter. There are Vallabh Thakkar, various builders and all that. So that is the height of fright they brought to Mumbai. Mumbai came to a grinding halt. The top of the heap is the old man, Karim Lala, and then Bharadarajan Mudaliar and Haji Mastad came little later. They are from Tamil Nadu, imported variety to Mumbai. And then they were replaced by Daud Ibrahim, a local Konkani, son of a Havaldar. The Havaldar had produced 12 children. He is the seventh of them. In 10 by 10, they lived in utter, hand-to-mouth existence, being a Havaldar in the crime branch. But then this guy went into the list of the notorious people. He is on the top of the heap. He is the most wanted narcotics champion in the world by the United Nations body. And then the counter this fellow's growth was brought about by Amar Naik and Arun Gavli. They were the Hindu antidote for the Muslim dominance, we can say, in a way. This Daud Ibrahim was assisted by Chota Rajan and Abu Salem, who all became independent later. That's a story which will unfold later. So this is the fellow, last he looked like this. Later, someone has advised him not to come back in the videos and TV and the pictures. Allegedly, he suffers from lung cancer and he's died. So every 10 days, they say he's dead. It comes in the TV, but actually he's alive. He wants to be live in the minds of the people. They say allegedly he's worth about 20,000-30,000 crores and the Pakistani ISI is protecting him. If we can admire the enemy for his managerial qualities, one enemy you can admire is this fellow. Even though he is the most notorious fellow, he blew up Bombay in the year 1993, March 12th, from 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock. There were 12 blasts, 257 people died, 787 people were injured, 1,000 people were missing, hundreds of crores was blown up to smoke. That is the enemy we are talking about. For that, he managed to bring 4,000 kilos of RDX, 2,000 AK-47, 2,000 hand grenades, half of which was kept in Sanjay Dutt's house, about which there was a case and a trial. And what happened is known to you very well. That is the history. This guy, the most uneducated from the Pratapgarh, Azamgarh area of UP, is having $40 million in his foreign account, allegedly. He's there with us when he was brought from Lisbon of Portugal. I was in the CBI, we worked at it. He's there since then in jail. We brought him under extradition. He's been convicted for the death of a builder called Pradeep Jain, 1995, and the 1993 blast about which I mentioned. He's there in Taloja. He's allegedly having $40 million, married to Monica Bedi, and this film world is his favorite play area. Chota Rajan grew up with this fellow, Daud Ibrahim. Left in 1993 because of the blast, and then he became a patron saint gangster for this, for the country, and he shot most of those 1993 accused when they came out on bail, and thus he declared himself as an Indian patron saint gangster. Now he surrendered in Bali, and then he is there in Tihar jail. He's taken care of by the authorities. He's there in safe custody of the Indian government. This guy was shot in his brains on 6th April 2007, but then he survived, and he's been arrested 2 months before by the Mumbai crime branch. His daughter was arrested a month before that, and he is the one who specialized in the Bollywood again, made tons of money, and he's there singing songs now as to what he did. This guy is a don MLA. He could have been easily a minister also if he was joining the right party. He was in Shiv Sena earlier, but later he formed his own party. His daughter is Geeta, is a corporator, and one more daughter, Yogita, he got married about a month before. He had come out on parole. And then he is sitting in the jail for having been convicted in this Jamshedkar murder. So these are the guys who brought Mumbai to the brink. So I'm showing all the pictures. Ashwin Naik is Amar Naik's brother. Amar Naik killed Sunit Katav and various others and died in the police. Salaskar had done an encounter to him. This guy is a BJTI engineer, and he is now under arrest. And he was shot in 1994 in the court premises by another gangsters group. He became waist below paralyzed. With that, he moved to Canada, London, Delhi, and ran a very thriving narcotics business. While he was in Delhi, in the jail, he got his wife, Geeta Naik, shot in her own house in Mumbai for allegedly having an affair with the police constable. So that is how the butterfly kind of life gets to an end. Suresh Munchekar is from Lal Bagh. This Datta Samant had closed all the mills, and this guy is one of those victims, a mill workers made jobless. So again, I would like to give a warning to all the doctors listening. Because of this joblessness created by the coronavirus and these landless laborers going all over the country, crime rate would go up. Because 80 crores of people are without food as per the Prime Minister's admission. So if that many people are without food, you could be robbed anytime. Beware of that. So keep your property under check. This guy is from Varanasi. He went into JJ Hospital, if you all remember, in the year 1992, and blasted two accused who were inside and shot them and walked away when seven policemen were protecting. 25 doctors were arrested in that. And then Bhiwandi President Surya Rao lent his vehicle, which was one of the biggest vehicle at the time. And then with a dome light and things like that, he went to Chandrasekhar's ashram, Bonsi in UP, and things like that. We got him convicted in the year 2000 for a hanging, but got it converted into a life sentence. He's in Ahmedabad jail. He is the kidnapping king of the country. Nothing less than 5 crores is the ransom he takes from people. So he is in the jail, but he is operating from UP jails. He is writing books and producing movies and things like that. Some of these things, which I can give you the background, is shootouts in the courts. Look at the date, 6th September 1983. These guys were brought to the jail, and David Paradeshi came in uniform, in the Navy uniform, and he shot them there right in front of the court. In this case, whoever shot them was brought again after 23 days to the same court where this guy called Rajendra Safaliga came with a firearm and shot them. Why am I showing this to you people? Is that there is no fear of law. There was no government. And then police was there in the court. Judge was there in the court. But then they carried a hoot about that. That is the kind of a fright I want to show. This is that guy, Ashwin Naik, was shot there. He's alive. But then the gangster called Ravindra Sawant who shot him. He was wearing the uniform of a lawyer, the flying black color coat. He has been convicted for 10 years. Ashwin Naik is in the jail now for MCOC. And he is also running a small time operation. This guy was one of the terrors of that time. He was killed in the Jacob Circle lockup. If any doctor is staying there in the Raheja Viveria apartment, they will be just living next to this lockup called Jacob Circle lockup. They walked into the lockup and the police was protecting an arrested accused called Babu Rashim. They shot him coolly and walked away at 3:30 in the morning. That's the kind of fearlessness they had. Datta Samant was shot right outside the house. He has nothing to do with the gangsterism, but he was a trade union leader shot right outside his house. He is the TIPS owner. His children produce movies even now in his name. He was shot dead because he was not paying the ransom money. This guy was one of the terror at that time. The other gang came to his place where he had come for doing up his hair and he was shot dead. One of the police officers took responsibility and got a medal for that. This is the shootout at Wadala matter. Manya Surve, John Abraham acted as this. And this is a shootout at Lokhandwala where six of them, Maya Dolas, Dilip Bua and others, were belonging to Dawood Ibrahim gang. He gave away them to the police and they went and surrounded them. And of course, Celluloid has brought out a movie. These are all the builders. I want you to see that after 1999, we began the operation. The turnaround story begins from here. There is not a single builder shot. From 2002, not a single human being has been shot except J. Day in 2014. That is the success story which would motivate you or motivate anybody for that matter. We could have been arrested. We could have been convicted. We could have been shot. We faced the very same dangers. But your enemy is an invisible enemy. For us, the enemy could be fairly visible. These are all the hoteliers who are killed. One way or the other, they were involved or otherwise, but they were done to death by dozens. These are all the filmy people, including Rakesh Roshan. As a warning shot, he was shot. That is on 21-1-2000. So that is around the time Chota Rajan was shot in Bangkok. And he went to the hospital and he survived and ran away to Australia and various other places until he appeared in Bali. If you can see, Anil Tadani is Ravina Tandon's husband. Manmohan Shetty is known to all of you. So these, some of them are dead, some of them are alive. The sum and substance is this, that is the Mumbai, can you pinch it, make it small? The Mumbai city, gangsters ruled, right, got it. The gangsters ruled Mumbai. Fear was written like coronavirus is bringing paranoid people. Businessmen were killed in dozens. Building industry collapsed because you bought a flat, they called you for money. You sold a flat, they got another call for money. Police morale was low because of the encounter petition filed by Abu Azmi, the Samajwadi Party man. He was arrested in the 93 blast and he got a complete discharge from the Supreme Court and became what he is now. Car sales nosedived because money was demanded when you bought a car. Marriages, when they were conducted, they demanded money. Thus, Mumbai became a Beirut. That is what we changed. This is the encounter petition matter where the Justice Aguiar investigated one encounter, false encounter, came up with the conclusion 95 others were also false. So the Mumbai police came to a freeze. They didn't do anything like that. Because of that, whatever operations they did, they didn't do. Because of that, the gangsters became supreme. Here, I would like to quote the example of the Kanpur encounter, which took place 4 days before. There is this gangster, and his name is Vikas Dubey. And on information, a DYSP, oblique ACP, goes with 20 others. And he had a previous information given by the SHO of the local police station. And he shot those policemen, 8 of them, including the DYSP, oblique assistant commissioner, to death. It happened last week. That is how we risk our lives. Now, if you call this a false encounter where 8 policemen have died and insider information is there, what can we do about it? I want you to remember the Batla encounter of Delhi, about which you have a movie too, politicized completely. What is the turnaround story is this, from fright to absolute bliss, no shootout, but thriving business is the story which I have told you so far. For that, I would like to borrow a quote from Sun Tzu, The Art of War. Strategy, ladies and gentlemen, strategy without tactics is the slowest route to victory, and tactics without strategy is the noise before defeat. So have a perfect strategy. I would like to quote this guy. He's got 2 inches less of one leg. And that is a great disadvantage to you and me for what he has done, Enter the Dragon. But he said, hell with the circumstances, I create opportunities. He converted that into an opportunity and became number one. If there was a Nobel Prize for that art, he would have won that easily. These are all the things we did. One thing I would want to say is that converting into the electronic intelligence gathering is taking the online listening of the foreign telephones in Karachi, in Islamabad, in Malaysia, Cambodia, and all that was the first innovative thing we did. Another is making an act, new act in 99 called the Maharashtra Organized Crime Control Act, under which even the cinema maker Bharat Shah with 2,500 crores property was convicted. Chori Chori Chupke Chupke is the movie in which we got him arrested. I was a joint commissioner that time. This is the period we are talking. We won the encounter petition. I mentioned about that earlier in Mumbai High Court and also in the Supreme Court 14 years later. That is what gave the morale boosting victory for the policeman. Police, a winning team was made there. They went and did what I am showing you now. We used the existing law to detain 1,600 criminals for 1 year each. Ladies and gentlemen, that means 1,600 man years were spent behind bars in 3 years. Every day we sent one fellow to detention, elaborate paperwork, and that went for a scrutiny to the High Court. We won them to the extent of 95% cases, in which these extortionists who called you were also there. I want to remind you one doctor Shetty, Deepak Shetty in Kalyan, was not paying money. And then the gangster got admitted in the hospital. When he was bending to examine him with a stethoscope, he took out a pistol from below the pillow and shot him point blank. I hope most of you know about this story. 800 doctors called me for a meeting and said, give us gun licenses. We have to have gun to retaliate. I said, nicely, I will give it to you. Happily, I'll give you. But would you hold a gun in your hand? And in the other hand, would you hold a stethoscope? Which patient is going to come to you if you are holding a gun in your hand? That is what we had an interaction. That was in Goregaon. Gangsters were arrested and we seized about 2,200 firearms. That was all illegal that was floating in Mumbai. We did encounters to the tune of about 300 guys. But after that, the point is this was done under law, as per the law. You know, Section 100 of the Indian Penal Code says you can do this act in self-defense, right of private defense, and the police exercise that. The good thing is, even though hundreds of policemen have gone to jail for false encounters in Gujarat, Nusrat Jahan case and all that, here in this period I am talking about, not a single complaint, not a single case, not a single court case. The fellows did as per the law and they survived. Maharashtra Organized Crime Control, I said, we arrested a few people, a few dozen people, but we got convicted within 1 year of registering the case. So that's a grand success. So these are all the details about various, this is the number of people killed by the gangsters. How it came down is this. I'll show you graphically also. The height was 1998, 101 businessmen. But from 1960, every year, they were shooting 20, 30. So are the encounters. But here, you can see, it reduced next year because of the strategy, which I quoted from Sun Tzu, it reduced by half. Next year, another half. Third year, another half. 2002 to now, ladies and gentlemen, it is zero, except one, J Day in 2014. There is not a single shootout either by the police or by the criminals. That is the success story. That is how the police could come out and you could, these are all about statistics, all that detention and all, which I showed you there. This is how the fever or corona attack came down. This is murders by the gangsters on businessmen, doctors, engineers, and others. How it could be done away with by strategies is what the story I have told you. So I could conclude by saying knowledge is free. You only pay for ignorance. Like when I check on the Google every day or in the TV or the newspaper, I'm getting flooded with all frightening information about the COVID coronavirus, novel COVID-19 virus. But I have to pay for my ignorance. I would like to conclude by saying that there is a thing called Ikigai. It is the reason for which you get up in the morning and wear your suit and go to face the coronavirus. What is my ikigai? There is a small thin book. Please read that when you find time. This is my ikigai. You know, feeding. Dr. Tushar Agarwal mentioned about the Roti Bank. I'm talking about that. 2018, we made it. 2019 and 2018, put together 1 million meals we served for these children and for various others. Tata Cancer Hospital, we serve 600 hot meals every day. It is not a leftover meal we give it to them. We make hot meals for these children and we give in Mankur, Dharavi and all. These are the Dharavi children. So the hunger virus, we are not talking about coronavirus here. It is a hunger virus, kills about 8,000 children a day. And the vaccine for it exists called food. It is excess. For each person in India, 200 million Indians were going hungry. If for each person going hungry, we were wasting 1.4 tons of food. That is 1,400 kilograms, mind you. But you won't hear about that in the media. Do you know why? Because hunger does not kill the rich. The ones who are suited, booted, they don't know what is hunger. They know only about indigestion. So I have brought this to the forefront to draw the attention of the people. This is a Roti Bank. In this coronavirus time, this is the coronavirus time I'm showing you the pictures, we have served more than 2 million meals. Dr. Tushar Agarwal mentioned about 10 lakhs, 1 million. No, in this 110 days, we have crossed 20 lakhs. And we are going 10,000 meals a day is what we are serving. You can see here in Mumbai alone, we have served 17,11,400 meals. And in Nagpur, we gave 2.5 lakh meals. We have started a Hyderabad operation now and one in Coimbatore also. We borrowed facilities from the hotels like Dadar, Midtown Pritam and others. We served food in 40 locations. Maximum of 37,000 meals during the height of coronavirus we gave. Every day, 10,000 meals, we ran into Dharavi and gave it there. And that is how we took risk. I want to gladly announce that none of our people have been affected by that. Touch wood, may God bless these guys for having done outstanding service. And here, if you want to contribute, you can visit the website or you can call the number. You will, if you want to, I don't want to waste much of your time. But then these are the bank details. I would like to urge you to visit rotibankindia.org or rotibankfoundation.org. You will come to know how we function. My goal was 2 million meals in 1 year, but within the first 3-4 months, we have crossed 2 million already. And in the next 6 months to unfold, I'm sure I'll serve another 2 million. So 4 million will be my goal this year. 4 million hot meals in Mumbai alone. That is what is the achievement. This is a book Dr. Agarwal mentioned about, the best-selling book. More than 100,000 copies sold in India, Radha Krishna Pillai. And this is about my life. How Chanakya's principles could be put to effective use is the idea that the whole book describes. A bestseller. Even today in the airport, you'll see in the bestseller list, 7 years, 1 lakh copies sold. With that, I thank Dr. Agarwal and Dr. Tushar Agarwal and Dr. Neeraj Bijlani and Dr. Rudra sitting next to me. And I hope I could bring some cheers to the people by telling a fireside story. This is a fireside story on a Monday evening for the doctors. I didn't want to talk on and on about the doctors because it could be very depressing to know how bad you are placed as on today. So I thought I'll divert your attention by telling a cop and mafia story. With this, we can go to the questions. If Dr. Natarajan wants to say anything, he's most welcome. Thank you, doctor. I finished my presentation in 41 minutes, 57 seconds. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks. Hello.
Yes, doctor. I can hear you.
Yeah, sir, thanks a lot, sir. Natarajan, sir, your comments, please.
Yeah, so a wonderful Shiva, as usual. I think I don't know how many thousandth time I'm listening to every talk, and every time I see a new slide, and that's what I learned from him. Because I want to tell the orthopedic surgeon, I'm an ophthalmologist, and he introduced me to Dr. Rakesh Sinha, who's a gynecologist. I'm sure I don't know whether you have heard of him, but anyhow, he died at the age of 59 about 2 years back. He ran an institute called Success Institute, but his hospital was called Beams, which he sold off, and then he made his own mother and child institute in Bandra and in Andheri. His son now, Rushindra Sinha, and his wife is running the institute, and they had a program where Dr. Mohammed and Dr. Sanjay Oak gave an excellent presentation. What I wanted to say is I always learn a lot from every time, because in spite of talking to him morning, evening, night, I think that's what I do every day. And I think for me, he's like my parent, friend, and grandfather, because I say grandfather because not for age, because whatever he says, I take it very lightly and I laugh it off. But I follow most of it. Very one or two I don't follow. That's why I say it's like I'm like a grandson. But what I want to say is, I think, I don't know how many of you have seen, many slides today I saw is new. And I think after he told me, only I bought this book, Ikagai. And like that, so many books. And Dr. Kalam is my good friend. And I introduced him to Shivanandan whenever he came to Mumbai as a president or as a past president. We met him in Raj Bhavan. We met him in airport, in the hospital. So he told me, Natarajan, if you don't have time to read, you should have a friend who will read a lot. So Shivanandan reads a lot. So if you have a friend who reads a lot, he says, you are carrying a walking library with you. And I used to walk with him. And every day he will quote like this. And that time there was nothing to note. But now in the presentation, I think we can all make a note. I'm sure this is being recorded. And I think he always quotes that seven things, like the vision, the mission, and talks about the character and all that. It is registered in my mind. And we in All India Ophthalmic Society started a leadership development program for the young ophthalmologists. And we had an age group of below 40. That means he graduates and becomes a super specialist by 28, 29, 30, and practices for 10 years. And then we expect him to do some leadership. So apart from doing ophthalmology or a subspecialty, like retina or oculoplasty, we train them to do personal management, time management, financial management, interpersonal communication, discipline, and excellence. So Shivanandan always talks about excellence at work, and Dr. Rakesh Sinha talks about mastery. So he actually gifted me a book, which I have, called the Concise Mastery, which is important for all surgeons, and all the orthopedic specialists are orthopedic surgeons. So I think that book we should read. It's about Michelangelo. It's about the Mendel, Charles Mendel, and all about, and that's how I read about Galapagos. And I went to Galapagos to see after reading that. And how he says, Michelangelo did not go to a school, and Leonardo da Vinci also. And I think they all learned art by observing nature, and they just came because they didn't have any photograph, they didn't have any camera, no mobile. So they came back, and in the room, they were drawing in the wall. And I think that's how Michelangelo and Leonardo da Vinci said. And I think our surgery and the art is the same. And Sanjay Agarwala is a very close friend of mine. So I always loved to be a consultant in Bombay Hospital and in Hinduja, because I could visit any other operation theater when I went for ophthalmic surgery. So I used to walk into cardiac thoracic, seeing the other, what they're doing in bypass and orthopedic, what they're doing. Recently, my 100-year-old grandmother, now she's 102. 2 years back, Sanjay Agarwala did a head of femur fracture under GA, and everybody was worried about doing GA to a 100-year-old lady. But I said, no problem. And I think that's where the faith. And that way, Shivanandan, as a human being and as a patient, he has 100% faith with the doctor. If he says, I have some problem, he asks me, we'll go to this XY doctor. And I'm sure Dr. Tushar would have realized that now. He has 100% faith. He'll not ask any question. Whatever he prescribes, he'll follow. I think, I hope the entire patient population learns from him how to be a good patient. Because I think how to be a good patient also is important, because many times doctors are a bad patient. So I think the points to pick up from Shivanandan's talk is, as he mentioned, he's a stickler to time, and which is very, very important for him. And he gets upset if I go late even 1 minute. But many times I go 10 minutes late, and that is off late. But when we were in Nevoor Hills when I used to go and walk. I was in time because he was waiting in the middle of the road. So I used to reach exactly 1 minute before calculating the time at 5:45 in the morning and reach there. And he's also a great example of, you can't make out his date. At his age, he retired 10 years back and he's still active. He every day has, he wants to make sure 10,000 steps and he's very meticulous in his diet, in his discipline. So I think may his tribe live 100 years like fit. And I think he's fit like a fiddle and he can do everything. And I think as an orthopedic surgeon, probably even, I mean, he also does that bone muscle density, which we both go to for testing. So I think he's a great example how to be a leader and how he's a great disciplined police officer and as also a great human being. And I think he wanted to do something. He was a chairman in our foundation, which is a foundation for twinkling little eyes. And then because he wanted to help me in collecting funds, he resigned and out from outside, he helped support that. And then in a few years, 3 years back, 2017 December, he started a Roti Pan Foundation. So myself and Sushil Jivarajkar Foundation, we don't do much except we are a trustworthy, I think, and we are a trustee. And we support him for all the things. And now because of the COVID, I have time. So I go and visit the kitchens. And whenever I get a foreign faculty, I make sure that he comes with me and serves the Roti Bank food. And it's so tasty and it is so, the order is so wonderful. It is actually, many times we go to the kitchen, we bring it to home and we have that as our lunch. And we don't the food is so good. And I think that it is like the, you can imagine, we have the entire lunch only that, the last time I think it was pulao. Sometimes it is khichdi with the vegetable. And I think when we serve itself, we know. And even for serving, you need a strength because serving hundreds of people, actually you need a good biceps and a good hand to deliver. So I make sure that now and then I go and serve in KEM. And so that idea is directly enjoy the blessings from the people. Sometimes they look well-to-do. What I meant well-to-do is they are well-dressed. They look like a graduate. But they don't have any sharam to ask food. So I think we also give not a wasted food or extra food. And I think I'm happy, even though he started as collecting extra food, but now I think he's giving fresh cooked food. And he could make like the Akshay Patra or McDonald's or Arvind Eye Hospital doing eye care. He could bring 20 rupees a meal and a sumptuous meal for a person going hungry. I think today probably in that overwhelming lecture, he forgot to mention that he said, if you keep feeding this hunger for people who are hungry, you can prevent crime. And that's how as a retired police officer, he started for the Roti Bank. And I think apart from that, I think even we busy surgeons, probably during this COVID, if you have either time or money or something, I think even as a surgeon, I feel sometimes I'm depressed. I'm a very positive man. But sometimes I'm depressed because not many patients are coming. We have 100 staff to pay. So many months I had a problem to give their salary. And I think I did. I'm also telling people, they are telling in Vasai they can't come. I have 50 staff in foundation. So it was a nightmare, but I managed it. Thanks to Shivanandan for advising me the financial management, how to do. And I think we have to do financial planning during this COVID time. So I think like how he started the Roti Bank, I think we also can do something. It may not be food, it can be anything. Some social service we can do, I think you can derive happiness out of it. And last 5 days, you won't believe, every day you're asking me, what do I tell these orthopedics, young orthopedic surgeons, how to motivate them? I also didn't know what to do. One or two videos I sent, which one of the video which I sent yesterday, he didn't play it, but it's a long video. Finally, it says, like, you should find happiness of what you're doing. So I think in this COVID, I have found something you have to do to make yourself happy, either help a patient or treat a patient or do some social service like Shivanandan, where he was feeding 30,000 meals in the last 2.5 months. And now since all the outside state workers have gone, he's now come back to 10 to 12,000 meals. So I think we are open to question. And the second is he said one Tamil statement. I now forgot what is that. What is that, Shiva, you told? That means, this is there in Bible also. Thou shall pass. It is there mentioned in the Bible. That means any tough time will not be there continuously. It will go away. So same thing happened in, Sundar Pichai has given that in the graduation ceremony 2 weeks back, saying that there are graduation ceremony happened in 1919 after, during the swine flu pandemic. Then he said it happened in after the 9/11, and then now in this pandemic. He says that means this over the current who have graduated, maybe CEOs, doctors, lawyers, engineers, they will do something great. So I think there's an opportunity, and except that one cartoon he put where the corporate hospitals are milking and the pharmacy people are waiting, which is, I think, sad, which is a fact, because the president of America is doing that, and why not anybody? But I think that's not the correct attitude. I think we have to make money. Let us make it legitimately, ethically. And I think patients also should know they should pay the doctor in the right fee. They don't have to be exorbitant. But I think like orthopedic implant, I know when my grandmother operated, it was few lakhs because you were whatever the T joint in the femur thing. It was expensive. And I mean that Sanjay Agarwal didn't even charge his surgeon's fee. But we had to pay a few lakhs to the hospital because of the special room I took. So I understand that if you don't want a special room, you should take an ordinary class. But the problem is people want the special room, but they want to pay the whatever that sharing room cost. So I think we have to do something to sensitize the consumer or the patient that you want a 5-star coffee, you pay 10 times the coffee you get it in the ordinary hotel, or 100 times the cost in the road. Like, I mean, 5 rupees tea, you pay almost 200 rupees with 30% or 37% tax if you go to a 5-star just for the ambience. Same thing, I think the patients have to understand. And I think I want to quote Dr. Badrinath told me, don't feel shy of making money. He says, make money, but make it legitimately. And at the same time, do service. And I think in the South, we have a saying, what the right hand gives, left hand should not know. And I think Shivanand is a great example. He has done several donations, many school functions as a school commissioner, as a police commissioner of Mumbai. He has on the spot announced 10,000 rupees. Like one is that SIS College, SIWS College, opposite Ayatejo, SIS College in Siam, and a management college in, I forgot the name area now. So I think everywhere he has donated. They call it D. Shivanandan Rolling Trophy, but he doesn't expect his name. But I'm glad he has that habit, because he says, I want to give and I forget it. And I think, I remember when he went to some Chembur function, he said, I went there as a chief guest and then I gave 50,000. And he will only tell me, I don't think he tells anybody else. And I'm telling that because, if somebody says, I want donation, he doesn't think, he just takes his personal account and gives a check. And I think that's a great human being he has. And he's a well-read in Tirukural, and also whatever Avayar has written. Avayar was a poetess 2,000 years back. Tiruvalluvar was 2,000 years back. And I think he has read several books. And I think he's a man of with a lot of knowledge. And I think there's a thing, subject called knowledge management. I don't know what will be the cost. I think there is a cost we can put for knowledge management. I don't know. He'll work billions of dollars. Thank you.
Wow, that was like very, very comprehensive, I must say, Dr. Natarajan. I am so flabbergasted and taken aback. A few things which I took from Shivanandan sir's talk was that there was no normal. We thought that it was a normal. So that was a very good statement to take it today, right? You know, we just keep thinking that we want to come back to our past normal. And we have to be in preparation to stitch a new garment. So it's probably never going to come. And now whatever new is going to happen, we got to have a new life, new clothes, new way of looking at it. So let's stop looking backwards. One point which I got from both of your talks is, let's stop looking at ourselves and let's have a higher purpose. And let's look beyond ourselves, right? Most of the motivational speakers, most of the spiritual leaders give us that message. And as long as we keep worrying about our own selves, we feel very sad. Third message which I got is that don't just sit by the sides and wait. Do something, whatever our capacity is. taking care of a patient, being taking care of our staff, or being doing any social welfare project. You were speaking, sir, one of our close colleagues, Dr. Mamta Jain, has joined us. She runs Medways International, and she's here with us, and she has one question for you, Shivanandan, sir.
Yes, sir.
Welcome, Mamta.
Hello, sir. How are you doing?
Wonderful, ma'am. Wonderful. God's grace, ma'am. I'm doing well.
Great. And it was a pleasure listening both to you, Dr. Natarajan and Mr. Shivanand. And great learning from you. The kind of difficulties and the journey which took for the police guys to come down to have no deaths of criminals killing normal people, we would have never thought of it. Because for us, it was a very limited and a myopic vision that we got it across either from the news or from the movies. We never realized that the kind of a strategy went into it and the hard work. The hard work that the police has been putting across, doctors have, and Mumbai, as a citizen of Mumbai or India, I can tell you, we have always been very indebted, be it 12/11 or rains or anything of that sort. And today with COVID, I think the worst sufferers were police guys, because I did interact with a lot of police, ACP and all of that. And I realized it, how much challenges that they were facing, right from PPE to everything. And we in a small way were coordinating with them to just get it ensured that it was there. But the hard work that they've put in across without any gears that they were fighting the COVID, just ensuring the thing. So thank you so much. Thanks to the entire police force from the medical fraternity. I have a couple of questions for you. The first one is, you mentioned about Ikigai. I've read that book. I don't know. I keep on trying to find my Ikigai. I've not been able to find it. I mean, either it keeps on wearing, or how do you go about it? I read it twice, thrice. Every time I learn something extra from that book. But somehow I don't know what is my Ikigai. So how do you come down to coming? Is it so easy? Because people talk about it so vehemently. And I think, oh my God, am I challenged not to be able to get it across, or what is it? How do you find that purpose? I mean, I'm an eternally optimistic person. So someone, I will always find my, I never see, like, because I'm blessed.
Ma'am, can I answer that first and then you ask the next question? Because I forget multiple questions. Can I answer that?
Yes.
With your permission. Okay. You know, even as a policeman, I was fond of doing service in health and education. So I built three schools, one in Gadchiroli and Chandrapur and in Thane, for the policemen and the others. And the whole money was raised by me, by friends contributing to that. The Thane Police School is 70,000 square feet state-of-the-art school, where 3,000 children study and 1,500 are policemen. Others are all people like you send their children. And these children go to Bits Pilani. A constable's son is studying in Bits Pilani. I met him in Dr. Natarajan's hospital the other day as an intern. His father is still a constable in Thane Police. So I was in my search for Ikigai, I was hovering around two principles, that is education and health. I built 30 gymnasiums for the Mumbai police at 30 lakhs each, free of cost in police stations, so that their health could improve. With the help of Dr. Sanjay Bok, I did 45,000 policemen in the year 2009, a head-to-toe medical exam free of cost, and converted the data to divide them into multiple groups, where in a coronavirus time, how people with comorbidities can be removed from death. As on today, 40 men have died in Mumbai alone. The whole country will be much more. So much more. Even an ACP in Ludhiana has lost his life. So that way, ma'am, I was trying to find out my Ikigai over a long period of time. I found in my long life of policeman's career that the root cause of crime could be hunger.
Absolutely.
So when we feed a poor child and bring them up to the school, two meals, one is given by Sarkar and one by given by an organization like mine, we take them away from crime. In so many Hindi movies, we see the child stealing that bread and someone shoots him or stones him to death and things like that. So that is what I'm trying to find out. That is how my Ikigai emerged from various interests I showed. So for example, service to humanity is a broad circle in which you can look for your Ikigai. Dr. Natarajan would agree with me. I requested him to go to Kashmir and do service me for those pellet injuries. The policeman caused the pellet injuries. I told earlier in a jocular way in the beginning of the presentation that we break bones and you people treat them. So we sent you clients actually. That Satankulam incident is policemen pulverizing those two people, the father and son. So that is a very sad state of affairs. But I would like to come back to you saying that in the circle of service to humanity, I found my ikigai of feeding children and bringing them up so that future criminals will be converted into bits pilani or doctors, engineers, IAS, IPS officers. So madam, since you are so young, in your own evolution, in your evolutionary days which are going to come, you will find your ikigai either in music or delivering lectures or building institutions. You know, so many things are there for you. I'm sure you're going to evolve into a person who is given to ikigai. I request all of you to look for Natarajan's ikigai is going to Srinagar 4 times. He did 138 surgeries, pellet injuries. All over the world, he does lectures with those slides. And he didn't charge a single rupee. Correct, no, Nati?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Many times all of us, probably you know your ikigai and you're not realizing it. But yeah. I think one thing was I decided as a 5-year-old kid to be an eye doctor because my father was eye doctor. But this 2 days before this Kashmir thing in July, when it on a Friday in a gym, he told me, "You are going all over the world. Why can't you go to Kashmir?" And he just told like that. And in the mind, I didn't know what answer to go. I just went back. And I was in Patna for a CME. And you won't believe, sitting in between the two talks, there was a WhatsApp message from some group saying that we need a vitreoretinal surgeon to operate in Kashmir. And that is the thing, because it was a desire to work there. So I came back and asked him, I already told, okay, should I go? Because the entire Aditya Jyoti Hospital staff were worried. They called Shivanandan and my other good friend, former director of CBI, Mr. Raghavan, called Shivanandan and asked him, is it safe for Natarajan to go? So he called me straight and told, he calls me Nati, he says, if you are afraid, don't go. He just told and he banged the phone. The reason is, if I'm afraid, I think I will die. That's what he said. Even during the, I had some other problem during the Thane time. He used to give me that acrylic rod and say, keep this as the rod, nobody will come near you. I think that's the faith. You just keep it in the car and nobody will come and attack you. And the same thing, when I went to Kashmir, he called the, because so many people called Shivanandan and asked, is it safe for Natarajan to go? And he called the retired DGP of Mr. Ashok Ban in Kashmir. And he told, if you go with a police reference or a police guy, you will be shot dead. So better go alone as a doctor. So I went there. I went there, the ambulance came to receive me. I went alone. The whole city was like on curfew with a like ghost city. Nothing happened. Suddenly you'll see some hundreds of people come and throw stone on the police and they'll be firing. If you are in the crossfire in the wrong time, you had it. But I think touch wood, my name became a household name. When they say ambulance has Natarajan, even the so-called,
insurgents.
Huh?
Insurgents.
Whatever name, I forget. What are the people called in Kashmir, sir?
Militants, militants.
So the chief minister was told by the chief minister that Natarajan's name is popular with all the militants. So all the Middle East TV came and interviewed. I think it's true. All the militants know my name all over the world. That's because I gave the interview. And then the chief secretary is telling the chief minister in the Maharaja Hari Singh Hospital that there were militants in the hospital. We don't know. Because everybody's in the same cover dress. They have the Kashmir dress. And I never asked a question. No caste, creed, religion. I operated a single patient who came with an injury. And I think all the TV, I told them, I'm a doctor. Like I remember the Second World War movie where with the Red Cross band, the nurse and the doctor will go into the war field and they take the patients and come. And it's there in the movies. So same thing, I told NDTV, I told every TV. Hey, don't ask me questions about the pellet and gun and police. You ask me about how to prevent. The prevention is don't take part in the protest. The same thing is happening in America now. The New York Times has quoted me again in the front page, as well as the American Academy has quoted, thanks to Shivanandan, not for popularity. They have already quoted because rubber bullets are being used in America. And the entire American Academy of Ophthalmology is coming over the federal government requesting no more bullet. Only 20 people are blinded in America. But here we have 1,011 eye injuries out of 10,000 pellet injuries.
Yeah, Tushar, you wanted to say something?
So I suddenly felt like a eureka moment listening to the all of y'all, and I felt that you can find your ikigai only outside of yourself.
Yeah,
so, so when the purpose is larger than yourself and the purpose is for the benefit of others, and it is with a selfless intent, only then I guess the ikigai comes. Otherwise, it is not going to come. Otherwise, it's
like we keep on doing it. It's like you keep on doing your own bit. But I think the way they are doing it is they're doing it in a structured way.
Structured way. And it's very magnificent.
Yeah. So it's like with an objective to take it across. Probably what I'm doing is doing my bit, but not in a structured way.
So that's what sir mentioned, that strategy is most
Absolutely.
Important component
Absolutely.
Of winning. Without strategy, it is only noise.
I agree. Mr. Shivana, one more question.
Amta, just a second. One thing is, the Dr. Shivananda sir has authored his book along with Dr. Radhakrishna Pillai. In the words of Dr. Radhakrishna Pillai, he had heard Shivananda sir and said, I was merely talking and Shivananda was actually living the Chanakya theory. That is why he took on Shivananda sir. So that's why his talk carries so much value, right?
Absolutely.
Before this, we were having many speakers, not to undermine those speakers, but I felt they were more of the meditative variety. Today we have a true Karma Yogi who is actually in the thick of things and has lived the things.
So he's a man who is really, he is the man who does the walk the talk. So that the point number 10 in the last page of Ikigai says, follow your Ikigai. There is a passion inside you. Madam Mamta, it's there inside you. And a unique talent that gives meaning to your days and drives you to share the best of yourself until the very end. If you don't know what your Ikigai is yet, as Viktor Frankl says, your mission is to discover it. I think you already discovered, madam. What I'm trying to tell is, every day, Shivanandan asked me, at the end of the day, like in the night, he'll ask me, what did you do today? Don't tell me you gave one more webinar. So today's webinar, he says, there's no use. He says, what is the end result? That means, have we done something to make sure Mamta finds her Ikigai?
Thank you so much. I will definitely. I mean, it's how you define it.
Ma'am,
I have one more question, sir.
Shivananda wants to say something.
I want to say something. See, in a group, elite educated group like this, where all of you are orthopedic surgeons and I'm an IPS officer and Nati is a vitreo retina surgeon, we are thinking of the higher levels of entertainment. See, Ikigai is a kind of entertainment. The literal meaning is, the reason for which I get up in the morning and run through the day. That is the meaning of Ikigai. Imagine the gangsters about whom I gave an entire presentation. What is their Ikigai? Today, people I'm going to shoot, correct? Today, crores I'm going to do extortion. So look at from variety of angles as to Ikigai can be different for different professionals.
Absolutely.
So you are a very highly educated, dedicated orthopedic surgeon. Your Ikigai is something, but Dawood Ibrahim's Ikigai is what? Blow up Mumbai? You know, blow up Taj and Oberoi? Or, you know, variety of other things? So look at it from variety of angle. You will get a kaleidoscopic view of what could be Ikigai for various others and what could be mine. And then I found out mine and I have started this. That is how. Again, Paul Coelho says that when you have a strong desire to do a right thing, the entire universe conspires
to do that.
That's what
I've read him, sir. I've read him. I quite like it.
And that is what would happen to you when you find your Ikigai. Ask the next question, ma'am.
So the next question is, one thing I would really appreciate, you're the first person I have said who has praised your enemies. I mean, you said that these guys were better managers or something of that sort. What is it which is a completely different perspective, and that is why probably you could think how to tackle them, that there was a strategy required and all, because you respected the brains or the intelligence of the enemy. I mean, which is tremendous. I mean, it's a fact.
Say for example, all these guys were uneducated. I can talk about it for the next 2 days, but one example I'll give you. How did they build a team where they go and give life for a gangster who is a team leader? For example, this Amar Naik is called Ravan in their group. So one of those shooters shot one cameraman in Chowpatty, you know, in the year 98, 99, 2000, one of those years. There was a bullet which went and hit that man, the target, went and hit a stone and came back to hit this man who shot him. It is called ricochet in the police, this thing, it's called ricochet, you know. So the bullet goes through the man, hits a stone and comes back to hit somebody else. In this case, it was the man who shot him, the gangster. Now, when this was told, he was bleeding, you know, he got injured in the thigh. The bullet went through the thigh. This was told to Amar Naik on phone, and this fellow ran away helter-skelter to some place. And later, that Amar Naik on a motorcycle, where he changed his appearance, in the sense camouflage karke, he brought an injection to see that he doesn't get that rusting. What is it called? Tetanus injection he brought. Now, this Ravan, Amar Naik, goes to a medical shop, buys that tetanus injection, syringe and everything, comes and administers this fellow in an unknown destination, and he injected it himself. So when we caught this fellow, the shooter, he told that this is what happened to me. See, my boss is one who risked his life. He could have been shot by the police. He could have been shot by the other gangs. He could have been done to death by others. But he risked his life and came as a teammate. He gave me anti-tetanus injection. Do you learn anything from that, madam?
Absolutely.
Observing the enemy and learning. So when I built a team where they went around cleaning up the whole place, which I showed you in my presentation, this is what helped me in team building. Show empathy. Look at them as your own family. So one of my policemen was shot in the stomach. He was admitted in this one of those encounters, admitted in Sion Hospital. Madam Deshmukh was the dean at the time. I went and met her and then saw to it that man was alive. Later, he was given a gallantry medal. In the Raj Bhavan, his whole family came after receiving the medal from the governor. They were full of tears saying that because of you, I am alive. I got a gallantry medal, you know. So if you take care of your men, your people, they would give their life for you. That's what makes difference in the army and in the police and in other forces or even gangsters. You take care of your winning team. They become a winning team only if you take care of them.
Perfectly well. Thank you so much. I mean, these life lessons are amazing. A pleasure listening to both of you. Thanks for the opportunity that he's given me. Thank you so much.
Sir, I think we are running out of our time with 7:21. Neeraj Vijlani has suddenly surfaced live here. Neeraj, you have any questions, comments?
No, I think it was quite a good coverage, and this was something new. The whole criminal life and how the Mumbai turned around. And it was something great which you have done. And Ikigai is something which we all know what it is, but basically we have to find our Ikigai. But right now for me and Ashok, the Ikigai is Ortho TV.
Yeah, so you're lucky to have discovered it, of course. And I must say...
Now, we don't know where I am, but for the time being, it is earlier it was Ortho Tech for me and research for him. Now we have combined it to make it Ortho TV for both of us.
You know, if you can make a book out of what all you have learned from everyone and come up with a book, you know, with suitably titled, it'll be a wonderful book because you are running into a lot of people who have come up with their ideas and you can take out a management book out of that and then publish it. It'll be a wonderful book too for doctors and others, non-doctors, like your Atul Gawande writes a checklist. One of the fantastic books.
Beautiful book.
You can do something.
That actually changed the way the healthcare works in America now.
Yeah.
And a lot in India also. Many of the big hospitals in India have adopted the checklist.
Correct. I have read the book repeatedly. The next book also I have read.
Even I have read his books.
My own operation theater now runs on checklist. So basically, I have also learned a lot from that book.
The book written by Dr. Rakesh Sinha, which now Natarajan mentioned, is a book called The Anatomy of Success.
Yeah.
If any of you can access that book and read, in a medically way, he has written how you could become the success. Please remember, the name of the book is Anatomy of Success.
Uh-huh.
my first meet with Rakesh Sinha was I did not know that he was such a flamboyant type of person, or he was a big man. My lecture was after him, and he wasted my time by putting his own laptop during the IROC conference.
He's a great friend of mine.
Yeah.
I told him your book should be launched by any cinema or a political people, but he said no. Shivanandan will launch my book, and Dr. Tempton Udwadia was another one. Dr. Natarajan was there. So for him, friendship and his admiration for people like me was the most important thing. I launched his book.
Yeah.
The Anatomy of Success. I request all of you people to read and learn, because it's easy for you to correlate to what is written in the pages. Because it's a doctor, a medical related.
So there is no lot of neuro-linguistic programming written there, and it's a very, very interesting read. So Neeraj, I think we should take this very seriously, that we can compile all our motivational webinars and probably make some printable, suitable book or some such alternative out of it.
Material, checklist kind of a book.
Right. Yeah. So with everybody's permission, I would like to conclude with two things which I got from the talk, is that we are not just survivors. All the doctors here we are all warriors. Okay. And we got to get into this new garment of a warrior, and we have to stop talking about, yeah, wonderful, that's the book which Dr. Natarajan is showing. And we have to stop talking about our normal, and we should know that we used to think that was normal, but this is what is the normal. So let's not call it the new normal. So as warriors, we conclude this session today. Thank you very much, Shivanandan ji. Thank you very much, Dr. Natarajan. Thanks a lot, Neeraj. Thanks a lot, Ashok. Thanks, Mamta, for making it so lively. Thanks for joining with us. And thank you so much, the audience. We love you all. You all come to support us every Monday. Please continue to do the same. We really, really appreciate. And without your support, we can't have this session. Thank you very much.
Is it live, Dr. Tushar?
Yeah, it's live, sir. It's live being seen.
Live, and you can also see the recorded version on a link, which I will be providing you after this.
Okay. Thank you very much. I think it's wonderful. I think
thank you.
I'll also request Shivanandan to send the slides, only the motivation part, not the crime.
I will forward the slides. He has already sent it to me.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Thank you. And enjoy a great day, everyone, doctor. And wish you, you're all winners. You are not the losers. A few deaths is all right, but with a lot of precautions, you can all be winners. We are not the victims. We are going to be the victors. That's the motive you should have. Thank you very much, and enjoy a great day, doctor. Thank you.
Thank Rudra again, who's with you again, next to you.
Thank you. How do we leave? Leave.
Ashok, kidhar gaya? Gayab ho gaya.